When Doom 3 was first released, there was a lot of talk as to whether or not it was Doom enough. And especially when you compare it to the recent Doom reboot from a few years back, Doom 3 was a massive step in an entirely different direction for the franchise. It wants to be more of a horror game, leaning into the parts of those original games that genuinely scared the shit out of people when that first game came out. The secret monster closets and dark rooms full of imps waiting to tear you from limb to limb. The problem is that not only does Doom 3 not really manage to fully become a horror game, but it lurches in that general direction at the detriment of the mechanics that made the earlier Doom games so excellent. Too slow-paced to be a good retro first-person shooter, and too fast-paced to be a good horror game, Doom 3 doesn't manage to find its way out of the wilderness. The only real weapon it has in its horror arsenal is the jump scare, the old-fashioned monster closet. And the problem is that because it's still trying to be a fast-paced first-person shooter like its predecessors, you'll sometimes just run right past those scares without giving them a second thought. And of course, we can't talk about Doom 3's horror elements without recognition of the notorious flashlight. In Doom 3, you can only have either your gun or your flashlight out. Plenty of mods since the game's release have gotten rid of this, and even the official BFG re-release of the game goes to a more traditional, simultaneous usage model. But the original core design of Doom 3 is to switch between the two. And it's clear why this was done, to add tension. But it's so poorly implemented that it doesn't even really manage to do that. There are only a handful of sections that are poorly lit enough to even require the flashlight, so when you have to whip it out for a few minutes in those areas, you know that monsters are gonna jump out at you, so you just pull it out, you have a few monsters jump out of you, not really scare you, and you're done. I don't mean by any of this focus on other parts of the game to imply that Doom 3 has some horrifically bad core shooting mechanics. The parts of the game where you actually are dropped into a lively arena with a number of enemies and made to fight for your life are pretty damn fun. But the game's focus on horror means there won't be a lot of time you spend doing that. You'll be spending the vast majority of your time not really fighting anything, just running through corridors. After all, if the game wants to properly scare you, they can't just have you constantly fighting things. There has to be moments of rising and falling tension. And that ends up ruining the flow of the game. You don't need to look any further for an example of exactly how it does so than a relatively early part of the game where you're forced to escort an NPC through a room illuminated only by his lantern. There are enemies to shoot, but the focus is on you not knowing where they are. It's not fun because the mechanics are still built in such a way that assumes you do know where they are so you can shoot them. As I'm sure you've noticed, before that offhand mention of an NPC, I haven't said one word about Doom 3's plot. And yes, Doom 3 has a plot. And unlike the recent reboot that really leans into the inherent ridiculousness of the core Doom conceit, Doom 3 takes the idea of demons released by human research in the most straight-faced, serious way possible. And I can appreciate that it was part of an effort to modernize Doom, to make it the kind of shooter that was very popular at the time. I'm sure the developers felt they had to add these elements to remain relevant in a very competitive market. But by doing so, they dulled Doom down to the point where it's almost recognizable. Unlike the Doom reboot, Doom 3 is trying to remake Doom into a modern first-person shooter. Not, as the Doom reboot does, make a modern first-person shooter into Doom. Still, I think that both Doom 3's successors and its predecessors both set it up to some very high standards. Doom 1 and 2 are still amazing shooters to this very day, and a modern reboot is one of my favorite games in the last few years. So while Doom 3 might be a bit of an oddity in the progression of the series as a whole, I think it still holds up reasonably well as a standalone product. But the Doom name simply does not belong on this game, and that's only been further validated by recent releases. In my retro reviews, I look at games that are at least 10 years old. what I would consider to be retro, and I'd see if they've held up today, if they're still worth playing now. If you like that idea, be sure to subscribe so you can see the latest videos. If you like this video in particular, be sure to hit that like button, and thanks for watching.